I think it's in the contact us.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the
Are you on a small monitor?
So basically, I'm a sophomore student, as I wrote, and I'm interested in deep learning and ML right now. And I have done some, tinkering with TensorFlow in particular. Like I did the Andrew Ng specialization on Coursera. And after that, I've been trying to implement some of my deep learning models. And I'm just interesting, in finding out what the capabilities of of deep learning are. I've read a couple of research papers and it seems really interesting. That's why I'm trying to get more deep into the field. And DFFML, actually, a senior of mine, they recommended it to me. It's a great project, and I was just having a look at what DFFML does, and it seemed pretty, impressive to train ML models using the command line and, making training easy. So that's why I started having a look at DFFML in particular. Yeah, that's basically it. But I just wanted you to know that I'm a real beginner. I don't have much experience in, any form of coding. I'm just I know how to use Python, which is a bit on GitHub, and that's basically it. I'm no, professional of any sort. I'm just trying to get started in the open source world. Right. Exactly. Is it, are you asking related to DFFML in particular or in general? So basically, I actually have an interest in machine learning, and I want to use that knowledge to basically get into the healthcare industry and try to solve some of the problems in there. So for example, just when I start j when I learned about CNNs and all the image classification things, the first thing that came up in my mind was to grab some data set which contains some images of maybe some MRI scans or something related to your body, and identify whether there is a possibly a tumor or something like that in that picture. So yeah, so then I managed to get my hands on a small data set on Kaggle. And then I made basically a small classifier, which just classifies whether your brain has a tumor or not based on the MRI scan. So stuff like that, a little bit. And other thing that I'm pretty interested in is in the math application of deep learning. For example, like I read a research paper that was written by a lot of Facebook people, and they basically had this NLP model which you could take in differential equations. In as an input, and they could solve really high order differential equations very easily. And they could do stuff that even Mathematica and Wolfram websites can't do using their highly complicated algorithms. So that was pretty cool for me. Yeah, that's basically it. It's sure, yeah. Yeah, that's good enough. Hi everyone. This is Hashim. I'm from Pakistan. I started contributing to DFFML like 2 years ago, and I was also a mentee here at DFFML in the last GSOC, and I've just been contributing here because I'm interested in machine learning, and it just intersects with my interests. I'm about to graduate now from my university as a computer scientist, and I'll be looking for jobs now. Yeah. Yeah. I made a PR for an issue. I think it's ready for review. Yeah, 1263. I added a sort of a test as well. I wasn't sure if we really want to test it. Because we weren't testing it for the other data structures. I think there was a reason, but I did it like 2 weeks ago. I don't remember it. Yeah, I think handling the arguments was getting complicated or something like that. Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
I think I didn't use regress to sources was because it was being used somewhere else as well. Yeah. No.
In particular, hello, can
We can't hear you, Shoria. Yeah, he unmuted the mic, but we can't hear him.
Hello. Are you able to hear me now? Hello. Yeah, I have a couple of questions basically, like pertaining to how beginners should start about their journey looking at exploring DFFML, the library, and that's about it.
Yeah, I noticed they weren't in the right order. Yeah. Yeah, maybe tuning models and saving and loading models should come before the others. Yeah.
Hi there. Welcome to DFML. Right. Sure, yeah. Windows, yeah, Windows.
Right. Sure. Thank you.
Regarding getting started with the FML, we also have a contributing section on the website.
Thank you.
I think he dropped. Just like you said, when you have been a lot of time on the project, you don't really know.
Sure.
I think you should also install from the contributing section rather than installing it as a user. Yeah, getting started, getting set up. Yeah. You can't keep up, huh?
Right. 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 Not in particular.
I just want to add that regarding the tutorial he's going to do, the video on transfer learning would be very helpful. I just want to say that everything is coming into place. That's really great. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, about the guys that you showed the tutorials to, did they get back to you or anything? Sure, that's cool.
I just want
You
to
too.
say thank you so much for this guidance, and I'm really hoping to, get into the community and start working on amazing projects like DFML. So yeah, thank you.
Yeah, if you have any issues, you can always, tell us on GitHub, Gitter, and we'll help you out.
Sure.
Bye.
Bye, everyone.